In this video, I'm going to show you how I use the log profile in my camera. First of all, allow me to thank whoever subscribed to my channel. This definitely will encourage me to do more videos and more content for you. My only request that if you like a specific content or you want me to do a specific video, please let me know in the comment section below. I will do my best to create the content that you're looking for. And if you didn't subscribe, please check the videos on my channel and subscribe if you like any. Let's go directly to the subject and I will try to do my best to make it as simple as possible. However, if you have any question or you have any further information required, please let me know in the comment section below and I will be very happy to reply to you as soon as possible. I made a video about the Canon C Log 5D Mark IV, which is also available on the EOS R. You asked me on how to use the C Log in the camera. That's why I'm making this video now. C Log profile is similar to when you shoot RAW in still images and photography. Why most photographers prefer to shoot RAW? It is because it gives them more options when it comes to grading the footage itself, that they can control the white balance, the colors in the image, the highlights and the shadows. And that's similar to using the C-Log in video, because when camera shoot video, if you are not recording RAW, which is a different subject, and you have the log profile option, preferably to use the log profile option. And that's what will give you additional options when it comes to grading the footage. So you can control more the highlights and the shadows, and moreover, you can deliver to the director or the editor the footage in log, where they can tweak it to a specific mood that they want in the scene or within the film or within the ad or within the shot that you're taking. This is the log profile in simple, but that doesn't mean that you need to use it at all the times. If you don't have to deliver the footage to a director or to editor for a specific look, or you have a scene where you can control the lights, in this case, you don't need to use the log profile. You can just tweak your scene based on the lightings and then you will get the results that you are looking for. However, in scenes which is contrasty, that means there is a big contrast between the highlights and the shadows, it is preferably, of course, to use the log profile if you have it in your camera so that to reserve as much as possible from the highlights and not to lose the shadows. So you don't have to crush the highlights and you have more details in the shadows. I shoot a video in almost midday and that scene was really contrasty. The highlights were very bright and the shadows were very dark. In such case, I use the log profile to maintain the shadows and not to crush the highlights. Let me show you the footage and let me show you how it will look on your preferred editing software. I'm using Premiere Pro as my editor, so I will show you on Premiere Pro what's the difference and how it looks. Here we are on Premiere Pro. I took two footage, one which is exposed normally on the camera, and the other one was exposed using C-Log. As you can see here, the difference. Now, the best thing to see the difference between both footage is to go to Metri Color. Here is the first footage, which is shot in normal exposure without any C-Log. And this is how it looks on Lumetri scopes using the Luma. And this is the one which is shot using the C-Log. And you can immediately notice the difference that all the footage is being somehow compact in this area. If you look at the graph here, you will see that the exposure falls between almost 10, which is less than zero, so you don't crush your shadows or your blacks, and maximum like 33 to 40%. And this is what Canon recommends when it comes to shooting C-Log. There is a video that has been done by Canon. I will put the link in the description below where you can just check it in more details, talking about how to use the C-Log in various cameras and how to expose to it. So you can see clearly here on the graph that the log footage is much more compact. All the data is being compressed between 10 to 40 almost. And that's exactly how I exposed in the camera when I exposed for the log file. While on the normal exposure, you can see that this is normal exposure. Even some of the highlights here is being crushed almost, because this is the highlight that comes on that dome, which is very like strong highlight. Now, when it comes to grading, this is the footage with the normal exposure and I already graded. You can see this is the final result that comes out on this footage. And when it comes to the log profile, you can see I already graded and this is the final result. Now, if you look at both, you can see the difference in the sky and in colors in general. Although I tried as much as possible to match them together. Even I went to the color wheel and match and made a comparison view between the reference, which is the log one, and the normal exposure one. I tried as much as possible to match it. However, still you can see some details in the trees, in the shadows, which is appearing here. Let me zoom this on the log one, like up to 100%, where you can see the details in the tree here in the shadows and the tree. You can see how the details here, even if I zoom a bit more, you can see still the details somehow all saved in the tree. While if we did the same zoom on the normal exposed one, you can see the difference. Look at this area here and look at it on the log profile. So definitely using the log profile will give you more details when it comes to the shadow, and it will guarantee not to crush the highlights. Even if we will go more details when it comes to highlights, like here on the Dubai frame compared to here, you can see the details, you can see the colors difference of this. This is a good scenario to use the log profile. And even if you try with the color matching, try to match the colors, you can see the difference. Here in the Luma, it's almost the same because I did already this color wheel and match. So you can see in this graph how the highlights and the shadows somehow matching, but the colors itself are different. This is the log footage and this is the normal exposure one. Also, one more benefit of shooting log, I feel it's easier when it comes to grading using the Canon LUTs, because you can just throw a LUT and then tweak it a little bit and you will get the results amazing. Please let me know in the comment section below if you want me to do a grading video on how to use the Canon LUTs, which is free on the internet and on Canon website itself. So that's it from my side today. I try to make it as simple as possible. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, subscribe and hit the notification bell so you'll receive a notification whenever I release a new video. If you would like to know more information or you like to ask any questions, please leave it in the comments section below. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time.